At a Middle-earth battle, they herded like cattle, but that'll look good on the screen. The Second Age ending, the Dark Lord ascending, his deficit spending's obscene. The foes numbered millions, or possibly billions, it's how Silmarillions get penned. Against trolls, orcs, and giants, they stood in defiance, the last great alliance of elves and of men. Their hero Elendil, all tricked out in mithril, he carried the sword called Narsil. With a warrior's scowl on, he rode to face Sauron. To the Foul One he raised up his steel. But Sauron just laughed, smashed it off at the haft. Elendil, he knew he was dead. This relic he trusted, summarily busted. Disgusted, he looked at the pieces and said, "You picked a fine time to leave me, Narsil. 400 legions of orcs in the field. You've been through some good wars, and you've been a good sword. But good Lord, your timing's unreal. You picked a fine time to leave me, Narsil." His final words spoken, Elendil got broken, but the broken sword still was employed. With one wicked flesh wound, his son nicked an heirloom, we all know he should have destroyed. This story may ramble, but it's just a preamble to the shambles which later occurred. As down through the ages, 1,200 pages, Elendil's resounding complaint can be heard. "You picked a fine time to leave me, Narsil. 400 legions of orcs in the field. We've been through some good wars, and you've been a good sword. Lord, your timing's unreal. You picked a fine time to leave me, Narsil. You picked a fine time to leave me, Narsil. 400 legions of orcs in the field. You've been through some good wars, and you've been a good sword. Good Lord, your timing's unreal. You picked a fine time to leave me, Narsil.